10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 20. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 30. Leg raises up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 20. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
I was picked under the DRS scheme in the army to be a commando, and they said you need to be fit. So just I did a push-up test and I blitzed it, and I did all my tests, and I did my psychological tests and I smashed them, and they just said you're gonna have to be really fit, physically fit, and they give me a list of things to do, and martial arts was on there, and my dad was into karate and always spoke very highly of karate. He loved karate, and then but where we were, there was no MMA, there's nothing, there's no martial arts. So yeah, when I lived in Edinburgh, I moved over to Edinburgh to get what they call life experience before I become this super soldier. And I started doing a little bit of jiu-jitsu. And yeah, and then I just found this sport of martial arts, MMA. And yeah, I thought I'm going to have a fight one day. So yeah, I just focused on understanding it as a okay, rather than just one flower. Yeah.
The benefits of training jiu-jitsu is that it could save your life, which is a sad reality, but for women, being out in the world is more dangerous, and having the tools from training jiu-jitsu to be able to defend yourself, defend your friends, your family, whoever else you're with, is priceless, really. The biggest challenge for me is more mental. Because I am the only girl on the fight team. There are six. I'm the only girl. There's five men. And I spend so much time training with people that are stronger than me. I try to maintain a positive outlook, I suppose, and try my very best to win. I would like to get a few nice punches, get a good takedown, and then do some jiu-jitsu. I'm not really interested in winning with strikes. I really want to get a sub.
I fought at Demolition 1, the first one they did. And I actually am mad at myself that it's been this long to actually get back in again. But it's always been a goal to fight professionally, not to sort of prove to anyone else anything, just to sort of get that life experience. If there's something I've learned, it's there are things you will learn about yourself and about the world only if you put enough hard work in to actually do something big. There are some experiences you can earn, and there's no other way to get them. And once you've stepped into an MMA cage, once you've actually done it, once that door closes and it's oh, okay, this is as real as it gets, and that guy knows how to fight. He's not some chump, he's someone that, has been picked to fight you. A personal growth reality that you can't get anywhere else. There's nowhere else to get that. It's one of the best ways to develop your own character by putting yourself in the most confrontational situation that exists.
Tools, I'm not an aggressive person. I'm not going on the street wanting to be violent, but it is nice knowing that you can protect yourself and for teaching people you're with as well. short-term improvements in my life, from everything, from my health, from feeling a sense of belonging with the team and a purpose, goal setting, everything. Yeah. The discipline in my everyday life, I think the routine, the structure is just almost like some form of therapy for me. It's like some kind of, I don't know, escape from everyday life.
As a kid, I was really into pro wrestling and martial arts movies, and I always liked the artistic aspect of it, the movement, the control to, do certain techniques or certain movements. And as I got older, I wanted to train martial arts, and as I started to get into MMA, it moved from just being an artistic interest to being a sporting interest. So I really wanted to actually train and compete, but still, I still had this idea of the whole art and martial arts in my head when I was trained, and I feel like that helps me. It helps me be, develop my game, develop my martial arts. It fuels a lot of what I do when I train martial arts. Mm. That interest that I had when I was younger, it still translates into what I do now.
I've always been pretty interested in martial arts as a kid. There's a movie called Three Ninjas, I think. I used to watch that as a kid. I wanted to be like Colt. And my cousin Terrence, he got into it, and he's always been interested in fighting as well. So it kind of motivated me to get into it as well. So I'm glad I started, to be honest. I've been training for quite a few years now, and I feel like if I didn't fight at least once, I'd kind of waste my potential, I feel like, even just to test myself. Think more clearly before I make decisions, I feel like. Take a bit more time to kind of analyze the situation before I jump in.
I'm living in that 21st century, doing something mean to it. Do it better than anybody you ever seen do it. Screams from the haters, got a nice ring to it. I guess every superhero need his theme music. No one man should have all that power. The clock's ticking, I just count the hours. Stop tripping, I'm tripping off the power. Broken, the school's closed, the prison's open. We ain't got nothing to lose, everybody we rollin'.
Because that cage door is gonna close. And that's a good life lesson. It's like sooner or later that cage door is gonna close. And you can put the work in now. You can choose your hard. You can choose your training to be hard, or you can choose your fight to be hard. Like, it's an old saying, like, train hard to fight easy. So that my motivation is I want to fight easy.
Is that is scheduled for three minute rounds in the demolition welterweight division.
And what's the post meal plan for after your fight?
Cheesecake and beer.
You could try to play, but you're never gonna be.